In this video, we'll discuss the key points for draping the ambulance patient care space in order to limit disease transmission when transporting patients who may be ill with Ebola or other special pathogens. Draping an ambulance is a slow and deliberate process. This ensures that the draping is smooth and stable, reducing risk to the crew of EMS workers once the transport is in progress. We'll discuss equipment required and the critical safety steps in the process of ambulance draping. Off-the-shelf products are also available for ambulance draping. We'll discuss these briefly toward the end of the video. You will need the following equipment: 6mm plastic sheeting in a 20-foot width or other draping material that is impervious and long enough to reach from front to back of the ambulance patient care space. Heavy-duty tape to attach the draping to surfaces, roll of biohazard bags measuring at least 24 inches by 36 inches, trauma shears or scissors. There's no special personal protective equipment required for the draping of an ambulance unless the vehicle requires decontamination from a previous care event. In that case, appropriate transmission-based precautions should be taken based on the risk assessment of the care situation. This process is designed for a team of between 2 to 4 people. Prepare the ambulance patient care space by removing any supplies or equipment that will not be critical to the transport. Before draping with plastic, cover the care space chair with 2 biohazard bags, one for the seat and one for the seat back. This will create an additional layer of protection. Unroll the plastic sheeting and carry it to the front of the patient care space. Place the center point of the end of the roll against the front wall of the patient care space. This will allow you to evaluate if you have enough plastic to reach the top of the walls on each side of the patient care space. Begin the taping process on the wall opposite the side door of the ambulance. Hold the plastic sheet so that it's just below the point where the wall meets the ceiling. Apply a strip of tape to the top of the plastic and the wall of the ambulance. Apply further strips of tape to the plastic and wall, overlapping the last strip applied. After you have about 1/3 of the sidewall section taped, return to the front of the patient care space and begin to attach the plastic to the front wall. Use the same taping technique, overlapping strips of tape. Follow the contours of the walls or cabinets. Make sure the plastic is flush against the wall before tape is applied. In some areas, the plastic sheet may have to be secured to and free hang from the ceiling. You will need to fold the end of the front edge of the plastic sheet back on itself in order to start using the long edge of the plastic sheet in the remainder of the patient care space. Tape the remaining part of the front edge into the corner of the side doorway so that it overlaps the plastic already taped in place. After the front edge of the plastic has been taped, begin taping the long edge of the plastic to the side walls of the care space using the same overlapping tape method. To prevent the plastic from billowing or slipping, fold tape and apply to the lower parts of the walls and bench seat and press the plastic firmly against it. Trim any excess plastic from around the rear door opening. Then tape the edges of the plastic to the floor and the walls around the doorway. Make a small cut in the plastic around the latch in the floor and reinforce with tape. Remove the plastic covering the vent at the front of the care space and tape the plastic to the wall. Remove the plastic covering the exhaust vent at the rear of the care space and tape the plastic to the wall. The rear doors are low risk for contamination and do not need plastic attached directly to them. Instead, cut a length of plastic from the remaining sheet long enough to cover the rear doorway and wide enough to cover the entire width. Tape the plastic to the ceiling, overlapping the plastic on the side walls. The plastic should reach to the first step on the exterior of the doorway. If it's too long, trim accordingly. Roll the doorway plastic up and secure to the ceiling with tape. After the patient is loaded into the ambulance, this section of plastic will be unrolled to the floor and will be sufficient to shield the doorway. Once all of the plastic has been taped to the interior of the patient care space, you should tidy up any sections of loose plastic that were created when short and long edges were overlapped. This will be most obvious by the ambulance side door. Fold and tape these sections to the draped plastic. This will prevent them getting in the way of movement within the patient care space. Sit in the chair and on the benches while taping, to be sure there is enough plastic sheet to prevent the tape from being pulled down. Any medical devices that may be needed during transport can be placed in a plastic bag before positioning in the patient care space. This allows access if needed, while protecting unused items from contamination. If possible, remove gurney mounting hardware, antlers and arm, prior to installing the plastic sheet. After the plastic sheet is installed, make small incisions in the plastic, reattach the hardware, and seal any gaps in the plastic with tape. If removing the gurney mounting hardware is not possible, you will need to cut the plastic sheet so that it can be placed around the hardware. Seal and reinforce openings with tape to keep the plastic sheet in place. The ceiling does not need to be covered with the plastic sheet. It can be difficult to fully adhere the tape to the ceiling due to the weight of the plastic sheet. The ceiling surface is easily wiped and not at high risk of contamination. If an ambulance is draped well in advance of a transport, be aware of the need to do a safety check to ensure that the tape has not loosened from humidity or the weight of the material. Off-the-shelf, patient-space infection control systems can also be used. Generally, these are one-piece, single-use devices and will include appropriate fasteners for securing within the ambulance. Sometimes these products are difficult to get a good fit, but they are often quick to deploy. Your team will need to weigh out the costs and benefits of these products as you exercise your ambulance draping process. Ambulance draping is a slow and deliberate process to keep the surfaces of the care space protected from contamination during the transport of a patient who may be ill with Ebola or other special pathogens. Protecting the community is a critical part of emergency medical services response when providing this type of transport using a typical transport service vehicle. Ambulance draping is a step-by-step process that requires practice and exercising to develop a process that will work for your team. We hope you found these critical safety steps helpful as you develop your team's plan.